Thank you. This year, the team has been through a lot of coaches and changes over the years, but it's always been a good time because of the guys that made this team. I'd like to tell all the other guys that might be listening to keep working hard and always make sure that you are enjoying and loving the game. Finally, I'd like to thank God for all he has given me and allowing me to play this sport of basketball. It's something that I will always be thankful for. Jacob Knight. Next is Bryce Nash. Yeah! I'm Bryce Nash. I'm a senior at the high school. I've gone to the school for almost my whole life. I've played basketball for almost my whole life, and I also shoot the school for the school's track shooting team. I like to fish and hunt when I'm not in school. After school, I will join the Marine Corps. Bryce Nash. Yeah! Sports. There are many reasons why I love basketball, but the main reason has got to be the way the coaches push us to play, to be excellent all the time. Practices can get heated and tiring because of the desire to push one another to the limits. Doing this creates a connection between your teammates and becomes less of a team and more like a family. After high school, I'll be playing golf at IU Kokomo. While in college, I will get my business degree, and after college, I hope to pursue a path in real estate. Davis Pearson. Next is Gabe Rozier. Basketball since I was a little kid, and the coaches and many other people I've had supporting me have made basketball one of the many things I love spending my time doing. My favorite memory from basketball thus far was meeting Faith Christian at home this year and the many Grace tournaments. After high school, I plan to go to college to study business or accounting and possibly play baseball. I'm very excited to see the plan that God has for the rest of my life. Gabe Rozier. CHS has been a journey. I really enjoy and appreciate the teachers and coaches here who put their time and effort to make me not only a better athlete, but a better person. I've played basketball all 4 years of high school and have made some great memories. I'm thankful for every coach I've had throughout the time. My plans after high school are to attend Northwestern in Iowa and get a degree in business and pitch some baseballs there. Boone Terpstra.
About a million times if I'm going to cry. I'll try. Our first senior is Jace Boltima. It took me a little bit to get a good read on Jace when I started coaching him. But he confused me. You know, here's this super athletic kid who works his tail off, he hates to lose, and is a fierce competitor. But then, on the other hand, he has an extensive collection of superhero socks and is working on some pretty intricate Lego models. So, a little confusing. He doesn't really fit in any stereotypical boxes in all the best ways. Jace is such a joy to be around, that is, when he's not making fun of me, which I guess is not very often. But during a long and grueling season, Jace makes practices and bus rides a lot more fun. Sometimes with a joke or an off-the-wall comment that you cannot help but laugh at. But beneath all that, Jace is an extremely high-character young man. Throughout these last few years, through the ups and downs, we could always count on Jace in crunch time to be a great teammate. He was always ready to step up when his number was called or take a back seat when it wasn't. And that is the kind of resiliency is what makes him such a key part of this team and this school. So let's give it up for Jace Bowling. Next up we have Jacob Dunn. You know, as a coach, you have a lot of preconceived notions and philosophies that we hold to. Coming into DMC, I had one challenge by Jake that I never really thought I would love him. I really had to wrestle with the question of, can a mullet look that cool? But once you saw Jake running down the court, his hair flying in the wind, there was really no question anymore. He pulled it up. Last year, Jake stepped up big for us and took over our point guard role on a team that really hadn't had a true point guard in a while. And as a first-year starter, he became a huge piece of our team's success on defensive and offensive ends of the floor. But for those who know him, know that it's really no surprise he excelled in that role. I think it's partially because Jake hates losing more than maybe anyone I've ever met. And it's not just on the court. You probably wouldn't be able to tell by looking at him, but Jake is kind of a nerd. And by that, I mean he's a fantastic student. Jake demands excellence from himself in all areas and pushes himself to achieve it. But for someone with such high expectations, he has maturity well beyond his years. There have been more than a few times in the locker room where I'm getting on the guys about one thing or another, and at the end of it all, there's a few heads hanging, you hear the steadying voice of Jacob Dyke saying, "Listen, we got this. Just cool, calm, and collected." You know, somehow I'm like, "Yeah, you know what we do, right? We got this." Coaching Jake has been a privilege, and we're going to miss him greatly. So give it up for Jacob Dyke. Bryce's high school basketball story has to be one of my favorite stories in all my years of coaching, and I'm going to tell it because it's awesome. So Bryce's sophomore year, his battles and injuries, didn't probably have the season he was hoping for, and while a lot of players would have called it quits, Bryce continued to work and work in the offseason. And as a junior, we asked him to play a big role on the JV team. He was our only junior on JV last year. Many kids would have taken that as an insult and had a bad attitude or quit entirely. But Bryce did the exact opposite. He embraced the chance and continued to push himself. Then, after his junior year, he doubled down and continued to work. I really can't remember a time when he missed an open gym or an optional workout day. He challenged himself, took coaching, and continued to improve. And now this year is playing a huge role for us and exceeding our expectations almost everybody. Bryce's example and character through setbacks and hardships are an inspiration and challenge to this team and to anybody who knows him. He's such a fantastic guy to coach, and his example is one I'm sure I'm going to point to for years to come. So thank you, Bryce, for your commitment and dedication, and for leading this program better than you found. Bryce Nash. So the next senior is Davis Peterson. Most of you probably don't know, but to get Davis to play for us last year, I had to do some convincing. Turns out Davis is kind of into golf, I guess. So I reached out to him, and he just said he wanted to focus on that for now, but thanks for asking. So I thought to myself, I'll give him one more shot, and if he says no, then I'll just cry. So what I did was I put together a highlight reel of Davis from his sophomore year, you know, sent it to him and just said, "Hey, we could really use you this year. It looks like you have a lot to offer the team." And little did I know at the time that the only thing Davis likes more than golf is watching himself beat other kids at basketball. So needless to say, here we are. Davis has been a huge asset for our team and honestly helped me grow a ton as a coach. He's got a very unique skill set on our team, and so constantly trying to figure out ways to utilize his offense and defense in different ways has stretched us as a coaching staff and made us better coaches because of him. Off the court, Davis is the life of the party. You really never know what's going to happen when Davis Peterson is around. Somewhere between dying laughing or rolling your eyes so hard they fall off your head. Be immersed. But I'm very glad I got the opportunity to get to know Davis on and off the court. His work ethic and energy not only help him succeed, but help those around him as well. And at the end of the day, I just thank God that basketball's in the winter when it's too cold for golf, or else I'm not sure I'd have a chance. So let's hear it for Davis Peterson. It's really hard to oversell how great of a guy Gabe is. From day one, Gabe was at everything. 6 a.m., he was there. 6 p.m., he was there. Always looking to improve, always willing to take feedback. Some of those days, he may have looked like he rolled out of bed 1 or 2 seconds before walking through the door, but he was there. Gabe is one of those guys who just loves seeing succeed. Through the last 2 years at BNC, Gabe has been such a steady presence for this team. His maturity, leadership, consistency, and humility have laid such a good foundation for the rest of our team to lead on. But not just to the team, but me personally. Knowing you have a leader on your team who is constantly going to be coachable is such a gift. It's been such an honor to be part of Gabe's basketball career these last 2 years and get to know him not only as a player, but as a person. I'm truly going to miss all the conversations about random Northwest Indiana high school basketball team. And I'm going to miss Coach Menard yelling at Gabe to dunk every time he touches the ball. There is going to be a massive gap in Gabe Lee's DNC that will be impossible to fill. But everyone who has ever gotten to work with him these last 4 years is absolutely better than that. Give it up for Gabe Virgil. Start. My first interaction with him was from that bench, watching him steal a pass and lay it in to beat me in overtime. So not a great start. Didn't start up very well. So, I was thinking of what to say tonight, and I started to feel a little bad for Luke. You know, not everybody can be as fast and as athletic as I am, but somehow Luke managed to push through that and make it work. If you know Luke, you know he's a phenomenal athlete, not just on the basketball court, but on the soccer field and baseball field as well. And with his classmates, he's really helped to elevate not just this basketball program, but many other programs at DeMotte Christian as well. And I think sometimes it's easy to forget the pressure that has been placed on his shoulders for the past few years. For a class as athletically gifted as these guys, the expectations from the outside and inside are very high. And so as a leader trying to navigate that, it can be hard and frustrating at times. But seeing Luke grow as a leader over the past few years has been such an amazing thing to watch. I've seen Luke over and over again own mistakes, push himself to get better, and when it would be easy to blame something else or shy away from taking responsibility, Luke consistently did the harder thing. So while we definitely will miss Luke's athletic abilities, we're also going to miss even more his competitiveness, his friendship, his commitment, and his leadership. Ladies and gentlemen, Luke Jr. I just want to say how thankful I am for this group of young men. They're not only great athletes, but they're great people. As far as my 4-year-old Declan is concerned, you guys are basically superheroes. So thank you for letting me be a part of your basketball careers, and thank you for all you've done for this team and for this group. So let's give it up one more time for these students. So thankful for these 6 young men. Thankful for all the different families they've come from and in the past that have loved them here tonight. We're just thankful as a coaching staff that we've got to be a part of this, and we're just excited for the young men that you're shaping them into being. We just pray that you bless them through the rest of the season and on through the rest of high school, through the rest of their lives. We need to pray all these things. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Good evening and welcome to DeMotte Christian High School for tonight's varsity game between the Boone Wolves and your DeMotte Christian Ducks. We ask everyone to display good sportsmanship and courtesy towards players, officials, and opposing fans, having on supporting your team in a positive manner. We also ask that all children please sit with the parents or in the gym during the game. Before we have our national anthem, please join me in a short prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of athleticism in the game of basketball. We thank you as well for both of these high schools, Boone Grove and for DeMotte Christian High School. At this time, Lord, we also pray for the families from Kankakee Valley who lost some children, as well as one from North Newton who was injured. Be with them at this time and heal those who are hurt. We ask you to be with the boys as they play and keep us all safe on our homeward way. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, please rise, move your hats, and face the flag as together we honor America with playing our with the singing of our national anthem. The national anthem will be performed by Rory Bennett, Abby Vandermeer, Ewan McNamara, and Sawyer Brusing. paint to the wall.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
athletic department of DeMotte High School would like to recognize the fitness sponsors listed on that page on tonight's program. Tonight's future game sponsor is Oak Mason Dairy. Thank you to all of our sponsors and friends at DCHS for supporting the DeMotte Christian Athletics for your financial donations. You can support DeMotte Christian High School Athletics by visiting the consultant stand located outside of the gym in your cafeteria. Please use the designated area in the cafeteria to enjoy your concessions. Thank you.
Thank you.
Jeff Ball, the DeMotte Christian Ball. Substitution for the 1952 Bryce Cash.
Come on, Yeah.
shooting is decent.
Number 14, Boone, and number 20, Boone. Thank you. Thank you.
number 5, number 10, Bailey. And the line shooting is Will.
Right now, Thank you.